This broadcast of the Rugby Report comes to you live from the capital of the rugby world, Lock Harbor. Reporting live on location is reporter Kai Silas from the National Sports Network.
It is week four in the Popular Freedom Rugby Union, and we're watching a Saddle versus Camelot. Again, with my highlights of Asato's lowlights last week, you figure Asato is going to come out and storm the Wasp, and that's what they were able to do. Coming out to a 5-point lead after Naslando went injured. Again, Naslando, if you don't know, is one of Camelot's better players. But Camelot is a good team, unlike Asato. And so they came back and they pushed it. They were able to get a try here, Tumon getting the try. And again, the difference between the good teams and the bad teams, you can see that's evident on the replay right here, where Asato does not play good defense. If you're the last man, you have to take that winger. And again, you'll see in this replay here, Asato did not. Okay, the winger is pulled in. Tumon's able to get an easy try. But that wasn't Asato's only mistake. Look at Camelot here again. This is the difference between winners and losers. Okay, very little time until the end of the first half. They're pressing. They're not sure they can get the try, and so they go for the drop. Okay, and again, some teams will say, hey, we want to go for the five. We want to be greedy, such as Asato right here. Okay, they're pressing. They've been pressing for 20 minutes at this point. Okay, and again, two key errors right here. You have an overlap. Use your overlap. Don't go up against two players, okay? But they're able to get the ball back, no problem. And they have a chance to break it in. One more person to beat, and Camelot gives them a gift. Easy 3 points. All you have to do is go for the penalty goal as long as you're not greedy. What does Asato do? Yeah, we're going to kick it for touch. We want to get those 5 points. We want to win the game, and I understand it. They haven't won a game in over two seasons. Still, you take the points. Okay, look at him, how proud he is. Hey, yeah, I kicked it closer. Well, okay, as long as you win this lineup and you bring it in, this is going to be great. But with 10 minutes left? You have to win this, okay? Couldn't even catch it, but no problem. You're able to corral it, pull out the ball, pass it to your team, and rumble it in, even though you're way behind the game line now. Okay, still behind the gain line. Camelot gets it, kicks it out. But again, Asato feels strong. If Asato, we've been pushing him for 20 minutes? We win this ruck, we can bring it back. Just don't do anything stupid. Don't do anything stupid. Like stepping out. Final score, 8-5 for Camelot. And Asato earned that loss. We're gonna go to Union now, again in the West Conference. Okay, Union versus Rocky Edge. And again, Rocky Edge start off weakly, okay? Union with the run, just tackle the guy. You don't have to give a high tackle to start it off. You put yourself in a situation where Union are able to get 3 points and already you're behind them, okay? Very early on in the game. And again, Rocky Edge played really good defensively, but eventually it just wore out, okay? Union was able to continue to wear them out until he started getting the tries being scored. That's Tango scoring that try. Fast forward to the second half, and star of the match, Scarmilto, the starting lock, number four for Union Saracens, is able to score one try here, making it 13 plus two for the Convert, making it 15 to nothing for the Saracens. And then fast forward another 2 minutes, and I want you to watch this. This is the turning point of the match. Somebody could argue, well, it was earlier, but this ensured that the Tigers were not going to win, okay? We got a ruck down within 5 meters of your goal line. Look at who's the first person out of that ruck. It's Scarmilto, okay? And he's able to get the ball, put it in, easy try, okay? We're at 22-0. We're going up to 29-0 now as Union uses their whole team. They spread the defense, and Ayana is able to carry two Rocky Edge Tigers into the try zone with them. Okay? Now, the Tigers were able to play well at one point of the game. They're able to score a try here, make sure they don't get a goose egg. Wilson, a really good up-and-coming winger who's able to get the try, not able to get the converts because it's so far out. And you're thinking, hey, maybe Tigers have a chance. One word, nope. Again, Union using the entire field. Their winger able to get in the score. Final score, 34-5. Let's head to Lenita. Stanislav showed up. Well, actually, they really didn't. Final score was 57-0. And we're going to look at the table while we watch some Lenita highlights of them scoring massive amounts of tries. Lenita's in first place by a lot, both points-wise as well as point differential. Union second, Stanislav third, and the last playoff position is currently held by Rocky Edge based on point differential. Let's move over to the East Division. And again, the East Division, first game, Lock Harbor North versus Lock Harbor South. Strong team versus weak, 48-5. Nothing really to see there except a lot of tries for Lock Harbor North. In Port, Sacredicity showed up. And again, the turning point of the game is right here. 28th minute, Yugertrill, after a huge scramble at the try line, is able to corral that try. Brings it to 14-3. Port were not able to recover. Final score, 26-8. Finally, in Magna Carta, it's the Athens Invaders. No points at the start of the game. No points at the end of the game. Let's look at the East standings. Lock Harbor North in first, followed by Sacredicity, Lock Harbor South, and Magna Carta. This is Kai Silas. See you next week.
The Rugby Report was brought to you by Lock Air, Popular Freedom's national airline. Lock Air, we fly you there safely.